Hello guys, today I am going to discuss about hydrostatic forces on plane surfaces. First of all, I'll introduce myself M.D. Tariq Anwar. I am working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department at St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management, Gurugram. So, this is the lecture series. Lecture number 3rd, which is I'm going to deliver what is hydrostatic force. Means that the force acting on a body which is in the water or below the water level. For example, if you place a plate in the water, so what will be the hydrostatic forces on this plate? So there are 3 types of cases for plates or conditions. For example, plates may be vertical, plates may be inclined, or plates may be horizontal. I am discussing here only plane surfaces. Later we will discuss about hydrostatic forces on curved surfaces. Clear? So first of all, I am discussing here case 1 is inclined surfaces. See the diagram. Clear? This is the diagram. This one is diagram here. Clear? So this is the diagram. Clearly visible, plate is inclined in the water. Inclination angle is theta. So consider the plate width is B and length of the plate is D. You know the pressure at any depth in the water is given by equal to P equal to rho g h. Here we are considering x1 is the top layer of the plate and x2 is the bottom layer of the plate. Clear? So now we will discuss what is the pressure exacting on this plate. So if we will talk about top layer of the plate, there will be rho g x2 and bottom layer, sorry, rho g x1, and if the bottom layer rho g x2, and g is the centroid of the plate or center of gravity of the plate. This is known as x bar or mean depth. So after taking a small width or a small section, a small strip in the plate and integrating it, we will get the equation as hydrostatic force on inclined plate is F equal to W A into X bar. Clear? Where W is the rho into G and A is the area of the plate, X bar is the mean depth or distance from the top of the water level to the center of gravity of that plate. Clear? Now we will discuss very important point. Where this force is acting on this plate, which is known as center of pressure. Clear? This is known as center of pressure, CP, and it is denoted by CP. It is the point from which the total hydrostatic force is supposed to be acting. From principle of moments, the distance of center of pressure from free surface or water level This is known as vertical distance. It is given by the formula h equal to x bar ig upon ax bar into sine square theta, h representing center of pressure. I'll explain this further. What is ig? Clear? Ig is the moment of inertia about centroidal axis passing through gg. Clear? Gg means a line which is passing through center of gravity of this plate which I discussed. This is the line diagram. Clear? This is the line diagram of this part. Clear? So see here, force is acting at the CP. G is the centroid of the plate. X bar is the mean distance, which is from G to water surface. Clear? H is the center of pressure. Clear? So putting the value of Ig, X bar, sine square, theta. What will be the theta is 60, 30, 50, something. So hydrostatic force will be F equal to W into A into X bar, and H will be X bar plus Ig Ax bar into sine square theta. Very important point or note point, you can say with depth as the pressure is increasing, the center of pressure will lie below the center of gravity. Always it will lie below the center of gravity. Now we will discuss case 2, that is vertical surface. Hydrostatic force formula will be same for this case, that is F equal to W into A X bar, and H in this case will be X bar plus Ig upon A X bar sine square 90, because plate is vertical. Clear? So putting the value of theta in this case 90. We know that sine 90 equal to 1. So value will be H is equal to X bar plus Ig upon Ax bar. This is the diagram given in the notes. That is, I'll discuss here. This is the diagram for vertical case. This is X2. Clear? X2 is the bottom layer and X1 is the upper layer of the vertical plate, and X bar is the mean depth. Similar is the case rho g X1 and rho g X2. This graph is showing pressure variation because on the top of the plate pressure will be less and bottom of the plate pressure will be more. Right side is the line diagram of that plate. Clear? So no need to explain further. Clear? So Ig is the moment of inertia about centroidal axis which is parallel to the free surface. Clear? Next case is case 3, that is horizontal surface. Means that plate is placed horizontally in the water. So pressure exerted on this plate will be rho g h. Here h is x bar, because G and CP will coincide, because plate is not inclined and plate is not vertical. So G and CP will coincide. So we can say rho G X bar is the hydrostatic force. Put theta equal to 0 in this case for finding out center of pressure. So after putting the value sine square 0 equal to 0. Sine theta is 0 is equal to 0. So this will be h is equal to x bar. In red color, this is the line diagram of this case. Now we will summarize the all formula in tabular form. So case 1 is inclined, hydrostatic force is W into AX bar, and CP, that is H, is X bar plus IG AX bar sine square theta. Vertical case will be hydrostatic force will be same, WAX bar, and CPH will be X bar plus IG AX bar because theta is 90 degree. For horizontal case, W into AX bar, therefore CP will be X bar. Now we will solve some problem to finding out center of pressure for a different types of body. List 1 is the surface, list 2 is the center of pressure. You have to match the following. Clear? It will be very useful for finding out center of pressure for any body. Clear? Here we have written the value of center of pressure in front of the diagram, but I'll discuss one of them in detail. Clear? Take first case, is the width of the body is B and depth of the body is D. G is the center of gravity, X bar will be D by 2. So you know that CP is equal to X bar plus IG upon AX bar. Because plate is vertical, so sine square 90 will be 1. So CP will be D by 2, value of X bar, and value of IG will be BD cube upon 12, and A, that is the area of the plate, will be 1 by BD, or you can say BD because this is in denominator, and A X bar will be D by 2. Clear? So rectangular plate, IG is BD cube upon 12. I have already note down the formula in the CP. Clear? A is the BD. So after solving this, we will get CP is equal to H is equal to 2D by 3. Similarly, you can solve. I have already solved. You can check it and find out the values. Clear? Next case is triangle. Third case is triangle in vertical case, in reverse case. Second case will be triangle in reverse case. This is, and fourth one is circular case. Clear? The value of H, 4, 5D by 8. Now we will discuss the question, another question. That is, a vertical gate 6 into 6 meter holds water on one side with free surface at its top. Find the moment about the bottom edge of the gate due to water force. See the diagram first. This is the diagram. Clear? This diagram is in this way. So this is the diagram. Height is 6 meter, width is 6 meter. So here he is asking moment about bottom edge. Means you have to find first of all center of pressure point, because you have to find force which is acting about bottom of the plate. So hydrostatic force will act at the center of pressure. By using the formula, we will get center of pressure H is equal to 2D by 3. So it will be 4. Clear? It will be 4. So force will be W into AX bar, moment will be F into 2, because 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. So you can write F is equal to W into 6 into 6 area into 3 is the X bar. So F will be 108 W. Then moment will be 108 W into 2. Clear? Therefore, final answer will be 216 W. Now we will discuss another question on the same concept. So rectangular container with length, width, height in the ratio of 2:1:2 is completely filled with water. What is the ratio of hydrostatic force at the bottom surface to that on any larger vertical surface? Clear? Option is given: A is equal to 2, B is equal to 1/2, C is 4, D is 1. I have tick marked on the 1. So now we will solve this problem. So this is the diagram given in the question. Clear? This is the diagram. So see, this is the value of 2, this is the value on 1. Clear? I am making dots on it. Clear? So first take this type of diagram and solve for vertical case and horizontal case. I am solving first for horizontal case. Clear? FB means hydrostatic forces on bottom surfaces. W into A into X bar. Clear? This is the height, that is 2 meter. So W into 2 into 1. 2 into 1 is the area, is the height. So FB will be 4W. Clear? For larger vertical surface, taking larger area means that area will be, in this case, see the diagram carefully, this will be 2:2. Clear? And X bar will be 1. So hydrostatic force will be 4W. Final answer will be hydrostatic force on bottom surface with respect to hydrostatic force on larger vertical surface will be 4W upon 4W. That is 1. Now we will solve another important and very, very important question. That is the gate question. Clear? Which is has been asked in gate 2012. So this is the question. Read the question first. The automatic tipper shown in figure operates when the liquid level reaches certain height. Calculate the value of H when it is about to tip. See the diagram first and understand it. Clear? Here is the diagram. This is the diagram. Diagram given in the question. Clear? This is the line diagram. So see the diagram. AB is the length of the tip. Clear? So this is the length of the tip. Clear? So you can say 60 degrees is the angle and 1 meter is the hinge point. Clear? When it will open or it will be tipping out, that is the question. Tipping is about to occur when CP is at the hinge, means center of pressure is near about the hinge, means there will be a tipping. So therefore the value of CP will be H minus 1, because total height is H and 1 meter is given from A to hinge point. Clear? So after solving, you can say this is the AB. I have drawn triangle. H is the height. So after seeing the diagram and I have drawn the triangle AB is the length and h is the height which is given in the diagram. So AB will be h by sin theta. From where it has come? We know that sin theta will be h by AB. Clear? Sin theta will be h by AB. Clear? AB value is not known. So you can write, h value is known, that is 1 meter. So 1 upon sin 60 will be the value of AB, that is 1.154h. So x bar will be h by 2 and ig will be bdq upon 12. 1, here we are considering unit length of that plate, that is 1 meter. See this point. Clear? This is the point. This, that is 1 meter. Clear? So IG value is given. A is the area of this plate. 1 into 1.154h. Clear? So putting the value of CP, formula x bar plus ig upon ax bar into sin square 60. So we will getting the value. So CP value will be 0.664h. By comparing the equation 1, that is CP value is h minus 1, means at this point tipping of the dam will occur, that is h minus 1. The vane pressure, hydrostatic pressure or force is acting at this point, tipping will occur. So comparing this, h minus 1 is equal to 0.664h, we will getting h value is 2.97, that is nearer to 3 meter. Now we will solve today's last question about this concept. This is the last question. So read the question first. In the situation shown in figure, the length BC is 3 meter and M is the midpoint of BC. Clear? Then find the hydrostatic force on BC measured per unit width. Theta is 30 degree, but I have written here 60 degree. Clear? If we draw a horizontal line parallel to the surface of the water level, I will getting theta is 30. So remaining angle will be 60, because complete angle is 90 degree. Or angle rule, you can follow the angle rule. Similar is the case. So area of the plate is, considering in this case also, width is 1 meter. Clear? So area will be 3 into 1. Find out pressure or hydrostatic force on this particular plate will be, F will be W into A x bar. But I have not calculated x bar till now. So because vertical height in the question is given, that is 4 meter. Clear? That is 4 meter. But from B to C, there is a midpoint, which is M, or you can say this is the G of this part. Clear? So there will be this distance, consider or assume that this distance is Y. So after taking cosine rule, cos 60 is equal to Y upon 1.5, because half of the plate will be 1.5, because 3 meter is the total length of the plate. So Y value will be 0.75. so adding to 4 meter vertical height plus 0.75 meter height after calculation, so this will become 4.75. So applying the formula, F is equal to 9810 into 3 into 4.5. Therefore, final answer will be F is equal to 139.79 kilonewton. Thank you very much.